The boxers have been given their instructions. The seconds are out. The crowd is ready for another edition of Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing with your presenter, the boxing historian, Greg Rashid.
Well, I want to say swaddy cop to everyone out there, which is hello and tie, and also say happy Christmas, you know, the happy holidays, or whatever you're celebrating during this time of year. This is Greg Rashid, your presenter, with another edition of the Shoulder Roll Virtual Boxing Podcast. And this podcast, this is the third one, a new podcast I created, and I should back up a little. Some of you who are not familiar with my past, for the past over 20 years, I've been in radio, had a cable TV show in Denver that was a boxing show. And I have been a boxing enthusiast, and I call myself the boxing historian, since I was 5 years old when I saw Floyd Patterson beat Ingemar Johansson. And that, yeah, that makes me, I'm 70 years old. Yes, I'm 70. I'm proud of 70 years young. But anyway, that's when he was my first hero in all the sports, Floyd Patterson. And I really got into boxing. Used to talk to older folks in my community about boxing, you know, just absorbing knowledge about Joe Louis and folks like that. And just became enamored once I saw Muhammad Ali. When I saw him, first he was called Cassius Clay, but when he changed his name, that even made him just cooler to me with the name and all. But anyway, it was just something just I've always had a passion for. I didn't want to fight myself. You know, ain't no way I'm getting in the ring. I'm too cowardly. But anyway, although I have taken karate over the years. I was in the karate club for a while, for a year actually at the Ohio State University. I learned Shotokan karate. When I was in high school, I learned karate at Junior Academy in Washington, D.C., and that was Taekwondo. So I know a little bit, and I've been in matches and all that, but as far as actually fighting in the ring as a boxer would do, or MMA fighter, oh, I ain't doing that. No way. But anyway, this show is about just your imagination. What if? What if of a fighter? And what I use on this program is Title Bout 2, created by Jim Trenza. And it's a computer game. Also, it's on a board game, too. I first got it as a board game back in 1980. And I got to tell you, I just love that game. It's been with me forever. And when it came out as a computer game many years ago, I got it. And what you do with this, you just pit fighters from any era. And just, you know, imagine, what if? What if Sugar Ray Leonard fought Sugar Ray Robinson? What if Muhammad Ali fought Mike Tyson? Things like that. And I know a lot of you who are listening to this program, you obviously love boxing. I know many times you're probably sitting around talking to your buddies and said, I wonder if Tyson Fury could actually beat Mike Tyson or vice versa. I wonder if someone like Alex Aguilera, could he beat like Manny Pacquiao? It's all this what if that you have. And this is just basically a fun show where I use Title Bout 2. I use that program and we generate some fights and just go at it just to see. And you got to keep in mind, it's not anything that, you know, etched in stone. Because I could put fighters in the program 1,000 times. And it might be 50 wins for one, 50 or whatever, 50-50. Or maybe just 1,000 draws, you never know. But it's just fun. And a lot of people really have been enjoying the program. And today, we're going to do a bout that people are really excited about. In the welterweight division, we got Hands of Stone, Roberto Duran versus Money Floyd Mayweather Jr. And I don't know what's going to happen with this fight. You know, I know a lot of folks out there who said Duran will win, you know, because it's the welterweight division. And Floyd, you know, Floyd's tough. Floyd's tough. But Duran is a legend. And I should, you know, Floyd's a legend in his own way, too. In his mind, he's a legend, too. But Duran is something. So this is going to be a fun bout. 12 rounds of just action. Hope you enjoy it. You know, I'll have my AI commentator, Shoulder Roll Steve, giving his points and views of the fight. Hope you enjoy this. So let's get to round one. Sit back, get your favorite beverage. If you got some buddies with you, sit back and just relax. relax, get some chips, get whatever you got, some dip or something, and just enjoy this. Just imagine Roberto Duran versus Floyd Mayweather Jr. 12-round fight. Let's get it on. Let's get this thing going.
Today's fight in the welterweight division features Roberto Hands of Stone, Duran versus Floyd, Money Mayweather Jr. This will be a 12-rounder. The referee is Art Mercante Jr. The judges are Monty Oswald, Izvan Kovacs, and Paul Burns. The scoring is the 10-point must system. Roberto Duran dashes out of his corner to meet Floyd Mayweather Jr. at ring center. Duran misses with a right uppercut. Mayweather misses with a left jab. The fighters clinch on the ropes. Mayweather bounces off the ropes and lands a 2-point right jab. Duran misses with a right hook. Mayweather counters with a left hook to the body that scores 5 points. Duran is wincing from that shot. Mayweather follows with a 2-point left hook to the temple. Duran clinches and is warned by Mercante for holding and hitting. Mayweather circles to his right. Mayweather now has cut off the ring and pinned Duran on the far ropes. Usually Duran is the one who is the master of cutting off the ring. Mayweather lands a 3-point combination, then misses with a right cross. The fighters are in ring center. Mayweather lands a 3-point left hook, followed by a right cross for 2 points as the bell sounds. Duran was expecting an aggressive first round from Mayweather. The crowd is standing and loving it. Round 1. Points scored Floyd Mayweather Jr., 17 Roberto Duran, 0 round 2. Mayweather continues his first round dominance by landing a 2-point combination, followed by a 3-point left jab. Duran lands a partially blocked 1-point left uppercut. Mayweather misses with a right uppercut. He then lands a 2-point combination. Duran clinches. Breaking out of the clinch, Duran misses with a combination. Duran lands a 3-point left hook to the body. Duran puts Mayweather in a clinch. As they break, Duran slightly butts Mayweather with his head and is admonished by the ref for headbutting. Duran steps forward and lands a right hook to the head. Duran scores 4 points. Mayweather covers up immediately. Fighting out of the Philly shell, Mayweather lands a crushing straight right lead that sends Duran to the canvas. Duran is up at the count of 6, shaking his head. Mayweather scores 6 points for that one. Mayweather misses with a left jab, but follows with a right cross that scores 4 points and got Duran's attention. Duran looks confused. Mayweather lands a combination at the bell for 4 points. The round ends with Roberto Duran shaking his head in disgust. Shades of his second fight with Sugar Ray Leonard. Round 2 points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 21 Roberto Duran, 8. Round 3. Duran comes out bobbing and weaving. Mayweather misses with a combination. Mayweather slides to the left using a perfect shoulder roll, avoiding a Duran left hook. Duran traps the slippery Mayweather in the neutral corner and lands a 5-point right uppercut. Mayweather was stunned by that punch. The fighters move to ring center. Mayweather lands a 2-point combination, then clinches. I think Floyd is still trying to get over the effects of Duran's previous right uppercut. Mayweather steps back and lands a 2-point left jab, then misses with a right cross. Duran tries a counter left jab, but misses. Duran clinches, then comes out of the clinch to throw a low blow. Mercanti tells Duran to keep his punches up. Duran misses with a left jab. The fighters are in ring center. At the bell, Duran lands a perfect right cross that scores 5 points and hurt Mayweather. Mayweather's corner is screaming at the ref that Duran hit their man after the bell. Round 3. Points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 4 Roberto Duran, 11 round 4. Roberto Duran lands a solid left hook for 4 points to the belly. Floyd Mayweather Jr. fires back with a 2-point right uppercut, then clinches. At ring center, Mayweather misses with a combination and right hook. Duran's head movement is a thing of beauty. Mayweather lands a 2-point right uppercut and a 2-point right hook to the body. Duran points to his chin, telling Mayweather to hit him harder. Duran then lands a three-point combination. The fighters are in ring center. Mayweather lands a left cross to the head for 5 points. Duran's knees buckled on that one. Mayweather Jr. lands a two-point combination at the bell. Mayweather stares at Duran. Round 4 points. Scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 13 Roberto Duran, 7 round 5. Roberto Duran comes out and pushes Mayweather into the ropes. As Mayweather bounces off the ropes, Duran throws a deadly left cross for 6 points. Mayweather's legs were going in different directions after that punch. Mayweather immediately clinches to shake off the cobwebs. Both fighters are warned for excessive holding. Mayweather misses with a right uppercut. Duran counters with a two-point left jab. Duran misses with a right cross. Mayweather counters with a three-point right cross of his own. Mayweather follows with a left cross for 4 points. As Mayweather backs away, he connects with a two-point right uppercut. Duran lands a two-point shot to the gut. The fighters are in ring center. Mayweather lands a three-point left cross at the bell. Round 5 points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 12 Roberto Duran, 10. Round 6. The fighters meet at ring center and immediately clinch. Floyd Mayweather Jr. breaks out of the clinch and lands a four-point left hook to the body. I see some minor swelling under the left eye of Mayweather. Looks like it came from the opening clinch where their heads collided. It doesn't appear serious. Mayweather lands a two-point left hook. The fighters are in ring center. Duran is moving about the ring, trying to establish position. Duran has cut off the ring and pinned Mayweather in the left neutral corner, but he escapes. Mayweather misses with a left uppercut. Mayweather lands a right hook, though, for 5 points that knocks Duran into the near ropes. Mayweather follows with a two-point combination, then a right hook for 2 points. Duran clinches. Mayweather misses scores with a two-point jab at the bell to end the sixth. Duran looks like he's having a hard time getting traction on his shoes. The canvas appears to be slippery for him. Round 6. Points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 17 Roberto Duran, 0 round 7. Floyd Mayweather Jr. comes out and lands a four-point combination. Duran's head movement appears to have slowed. Duran is trying to cut off the ring, but Mayweather keeps sliding away. Duran lands a partially blocked combination for 1 point. Mayweather is executing the shoulder roll to perfection tonight. Duran clinches. Breaking out of the clinch, Duran misses with a left uppercut, while Mayweather counters with a two-point left jab. Duran lands a partially blocked left uppercut for 1 point. Duran lands a three-point right jab. Duran is moving about the ring, trying to establish position. The fighters are in ring center. My goodness, what a right uppercut for 6 points from Duran. Mayweather was wobbled by that shot. The bell rings just in time to save Mayweather from further damage. The crowd is on its feet for Duran. Round 7 points. Scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 6 Roberto Duran, 12 round 8. Roberto Duran comes out on fire, landing a three-point combination. Duran lands another combination for 4 points. Mayweather is dancing along the near ropes to escape more damage from the hands of Stone. The fighters move to ring center. Mayweather lands a two-point right hook, followed by a three-point blow to the jaw. Duran fires a two-point left cross to the stomach, followed by a straight right for 3 points. Mayweather with a two-point left jab. Duran misses with a right uppercut. Duran is moving about the ring, trying to establish position. Duran has cut off the ring and pinned Mayweather on the near ropes. Duran's left uppercut hits its target and Mayweather is down. The ref is counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and Mayweather is up at 9. That shot was 6 points. The crowd is going crazy. Any other fighter would have been counted by such a crushing blow, but Mayweather got up. Duran misses with a right cross and right uppercut. Mayweather counters with a two-point left jab at the bell. The crowd is giving Duran a standing ovation for that round. I still don't know how Mayweather got up from that shot. Round 8 points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 9 Roberto Duran, 19. Round 9. Hoping to continue his success from the last round, Duran lands a two-point combination. Duran has Mayweather backed into his own corner. Mayweather lands a two-point right uppercut off his back foot. Duran clinches. Mayweather steps to Duran's right and lands a three-point combination. Mayweather connects with a five-point straight right lead that knocks Duran into the ropes. Mayweather misses with a combination as Duran clinches. Mayweather misses with a combination, coming out of the clinch, then lands a two-point right jab. Duran lands a two-point left uppercut. Duran misses with a right uppercut. Mayweather moves forward and lands a left hook for 5 points. Duran is in trouble. Sensing Duran is seriously hurt, Mayweather lands a combination that floors Duran. Duran gets up at the count of three. Mayweather lands a three-point right uppercut at the bell that staggered Duran. Duran took a serious whipping in that round. Round 9. Points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 20 Roberto Duran, 4 round 10. Duran is slow to meet Mayweather at right center. Duran misses with a left cross. Mayweather misses with a counter cross. Duran misses with a combination, but lands a 5-point right cross that hurt Mayweather. His glove almost touched the mat. Duran lands a left hook for 5 points. Mayweather is hurt and trying to cover up. Duran misses with another left cross, then scores with a right hook to the body for 3 points. The fighters are in ring center. Duran misses with a combination. Duran lands a 2-point left hook to the belly, followed by a right uppercut for 2 points. Duran lands a partially blocked right jab for 1 point. The fighters are in ring center. Mayweather lands a 2-point left jab, followed by a 3-point combo and 2-point right uppercut at the bell. Floyd woke up to end the round. Round 10, points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 7 Roberto Duran, 19 round 11. With the crowd behind him, Roberto Duran lands a left uppercut for 5 points to open the 11th. Mayweather was stunned by that blow. The fighters are toe-to-toe. Mayweather misses with a right uppercut. Duran misses with a counter cross. Mayweather lands a 2-point combination. Duran misses with a counter hook. Duran lands a 2-point combination. Duran lands a 3-point right cross. Mayweather misses with a combination but connects with a 2-point left jab. Mayweather clinches. Duran lands a 2-point left jab. Mayweather misses with a right cross. The fighters clinch as the round ends. The crowd senses a Duran victory as we move to the 12th and final round. Round 12. The fighters touch gloves at ring center. The crowd is on its feet. Mayweather lands a 2-point left jab. Mayweather Jr. lands a 2-point combination. Mayweather lands a crushing combination that knocks down Roberto Duran. Duran gets back to his feet at the count of 7, 6 points scored by Mayweather. Mayweather lands a partially blocked 1-point right uppercut as he moves in for the kill. Mayweather lands a 2-point left jab, then misses a right uppercut. Mayweather has cut off the ring and pinned Duran in the left neutral corner. We are halfway through the round and Duran has not thrown a punch. Mayweather lands a 3-point combination. Mayweather misses a jab, then scores another 3-point combination. Mayweather lands a 6-point straight right. Duran clinches to prevent himself from going down. Mayweather is really throwing bombs. Mayweather misses with a right cross and left uppercut. Duran misses a weak right hook at the bell. Duran's lack of punching in the last round may have cost him the fight. Let's hear what the judges say. Monty Oswald scores the bout 115. 108 István Kovács scores the bout 114. 108 Paul Burns scores the bout 112. 111. For the winner by unanimous decision, Floyd Mayweather Jr. Points scored. Floyd Mayweather Jr., 155 Roberto Duran, 103. The crowd has no problem with the decision. The better boxer won.
Yeah, I don't have a problem with the decision either. In fact, I actually thought that when I set these up that Duran would win this. And a lot of folks who were aware of what I was doing with this about said the same thing. But Floyd, you know, Floyd's tough. And I could see, I got to see, as I listened to this, it reminded me in a sense of the second Sugar Ray Leonard versus a Roberto Duran fight, the famous No Mas fight. But I could see Floyd like just frustrating Duran. And also Duran, having the wrong shoes on the canvas and he's like slipping and all that. And he can't handle that. I could see him going down. And also I could see Roberto knocking Floyd down too. But not knocking him out. Floyd has a tremendous chin. As did Duran, but I could see that. So I don't have a problem with this bout. Maybe I'll try this at some point if you want it out there, folks listening. Both of them fighting at lightweight. But this is your show. And I have people out there who are promoting shows. I have a whole list of shows that are coming up based on listeners like you who have promoted some shows. And if you want to promote a show, you have two fighters that you want to get together, a what if match, going in a time machine, having these guys fight at their peak. Just go on my Facebook site, Gregory Rashid. Also, you can go to the site of Sports Simulations. You'll see this podcast on there. Also, go to my YouTube site. My new YouTube channel is, I have a lot of folks that love it on there, love this show on there. And I'm talking about Nourished by History. Again, Nourished by History. Please go to that YouTube site. Really want you to go there. But I just, and I have to say this as far as housekeeping. I can do fighters from 2010 on back. I don't have any current fighters except for Anthony Joshua. I have also Tyson Fury, Daniel Dubois. I have Wilder, DeAndre Wilder. I think I have Andy Ruiz. I think I have Andy Ruiz, but that's about it. And no, I don't have Suki. I don't have him. But and by the way, I should say this. I know some of you probably listened to or looked at, in particular, the Day of Reckoning in Saudi Arabia, where some of the fighters I just mentioned were fighting on the bout. And we're just gonna talk about the, I want to talk about real quickly the three heavyweights, starting with Anthony Joshua against Otis Owellan. And he Joshua has not looked like that in years. I mean, he's lost three fights in a row to Usyk twice, and also he lost the fight to Andy. He lost to Andy Ruiz, but he won the title. He won his title back with that one. But anyway, so it's three out of four fights actually he has lost. But he looked good in that. I mean, he really looked good. And Otis Welland is not a bum. He gave Tyson Fury a fight and a half. Busted his face open, and if it was any other fighter, they would have stopped that fight and given that fight to Otis Welland because of Tyson Fury, and they wanted Tyson Fury to win, not lose. He got the win. He got the win. But Otis Welland was no joke. But he didn't know he was going to expect this type of Anthony Joshua, and Joshua put a number on him. And I can see Joshua now. I hope the next fight is him against the winner of Usyk and Tyson Fury. And I think right now, this Joshua could beat either one of them. If he remains like this, he could beat either one of them. The other two fights in the heavyweight division at night, you had Deontay Wilder versus Joseph Parker. And I've seen a lot of people on the web saying that. Questioning, like, say, what's wrong with a Wilder? But forgetting that Joseph Parker, he fought a hell of a fight. I mean, he's no chump. He's a former heavyweight champion. And he put a number on Wilder. And Wilder, in my opinion, he didn't win a round, he didn't do anything. Wilder looked like he was fast asleep. He was holding, he was clinching. He didn't look good at all. And Wilder, I've always liked him as a fighter, but I knew the day of reckoning would come. And it came against Fury in a sense, but you can, he doesn't, he, and he has skills, but he never uses them. He has a great left jab, but he always loaded up that right hand. And eventually it's going to catch up with him. And he was really sloppy in his fight. And in his fights, his last two fights against Fury, he was really sloppy. And he's just, you know, at the age of 38, I don't think he'll get it together. And I know this talk about, even though he lost, they want to put him in against Joshua. And I really don't want to see that. I'd rather see Parker fight Joshua in a rematch. They fought many years ago. It wasn't the most exciting fight. But I'd like to see that again. But Wilder, if he's to fight somebody, I want him to see him fight Andy Ruiz. I think that'd be like Rock'em Sock'em Robot. In fact, you know, I really hope they put that one together. The other heavyweight fight that happened that night, excuse me, another fight that happened was Big Baby Miller versus Daniel Dubois. And Big Baby, Jarrell Big Baby Miller, he was talking so much smack. But the funny thing is, he's over in Saudi Arabia. And he got religion all of a sudden. And I saw this on YouTube where he gave his life to Islam. He's a Muslim now. But his actions after that did not reflect that of a Muslim, but just reflected someone that was just a bully. And I'm glad that Dubois just beat him in the last round. He was beating the whole fight, but the last round, they had to stop that fight because he just put a whipping on that big baby. He spanked the big baby. And Dubois, I didn't actually think he would win that fight because Dubois, you know, he's the typical British heavyweight. And I got to put Joshua in there too. They have these glass jaws and they, you know, get hit. They get hit hard, but also if they get hit, they're going down. And I, you know, I don't know, you know, I would like to see Joshua and Dubois fight. I would like to see that. I don't think they're going to do that. But I would love to see those two fight, just to see what happens. Because Dubois, you know, he's good. You know, he has great skill. In fact, I think he's better than Bruno. You know, Bruno when he was at his peak. He has a lot of skills there, but he's got that glass jaw. But we'll see what these folks will do, these promoters will do, as far as lining up fights, Eddie Hearn, you know, and all other folks, what they'll line up. But you as a promoter, you out there, you have the opportunity to promote a fight here, line up some fighters for this show, because this is your show. This is your show. And besides doing fights on here, we're also going to interview folks, fighters, authors who have written books on boxing, and not just about boxing, because we'll be talking about combat sports. And since I'm over here in Thailand, you know, I'll be devoting some of the shows to Muay Thai boxing, you know, things like that, that I'm sure that you'll find very entertaining. And also, I'll be putting music on the show, as I'm going to do right now. To conclude my show today, I'm going to play a boxing song, in a sense, because it's a holiday season. I'm going to do this one by Sister Winona Carr. It's called 15 Rounds for Jesus. So I'm going to get out of here right now. This is Greg Rashid, your presenter. Go in love and go in peace. Help someone along the way, because you can't help anyone. You can't help yourself. So you got to help folks in your community, wherever you can, be it a young person, a senior, anyone. Help them. And when you wake up every morning, before you do anything, get up and stay, look in that mirror and say, I love myself. Hug yourself and just say you love yourself. Because by doing that, you'll just have a great feeling all day. And if you're sight impaired, get up and just hug yourself and say, I love myself. It'll do so much for you. And it'll do so much for you the whole day when you go out and you really want to help someone. Because that's all it's about. But again, this is Greg Rashid. We're all in this together. Go in love and go in peace. And remember, keep that guard up as we listen to Sister Winona Carr, 15 Rounds for Jesus.
Round.
Thanks for tuning in. See you next time.